Alright guys, I'm gonna give you a total sneak preview of my favorite resource, which is my color and color theory workbook. So it is an essential resource for teaching art, and it's going to give you all those templates that you have been searching through Pinterest for, in Facebook groups, searching the internet for. Just end that, because this is it. I'm going to show you my color and color wheel and color theory resource. It is perfect for art on a cart, perfect as an essential program in your classroom, providing with all the worksheets and templates that you need for teaching analogous colors, complementary colors, your secondary colors, color wheel, all that jazz is included. Tints, tones, and shades, just value, everything. So let's dive on into it. I'm gonna show you first just some of the pages printed, and so you can see it as a printed booklet. I'll do some of the pages with you, and then I'm also going to show you a screen flip through of all the pages included in this resource. So let's dive on in and check it out. All right, so this is just some of the pages included in the color theory booklet. I'm just gonna go through some of them, and then I'm gonna show the full screen preview of the whole thing. So just showing you some of the pages right now. I love this. This is one of those essential resources that you must have in your classroom. So it goes through color mixing and color theory. It gives you all those templates that you are dying to have and trying to find all over the internet, and sometimes they're great and sometimes So this is one of those ones that you must have. It's great for you to use. You can print it as a booklet or just give out individual pages, or maybe double side some of them if you wanted to break it up. If you're art on a cart, you can photocopy the whole thing, stick it in Duotangs, and then you're done prepping for a long time. Kids can just bring them out when you arrive at class and then work through it, or you can even use it as your emergency sub tub. This resource is both is available in two places, both in my Teachers Pay Teacher store, Ms Artastic, or with your Artastic Collective membership in the themes section. So check it out when it arrives. So first page is mixing the secondary colors below. So just you can use whatever art mediums you have. You don't necessarily need to use paint. If you want to use paint, you can, but you can experiment with other things such as your wax crayons, felt markers, oil pastels, or soft pastels. Often I think we get stuck on thinking that mixing colors has to be done with paint, and it can be done with paint, but you can use whatever you want. Okay, so feel free to be creative. If you are not really wanting to pull out the paint every single time, or use it to teach color mixing, you don't have to. You can for some of the pages, and then other pages you can, like this is just wax crayon, you get those colors there. I can show you it with oil pastels. They are amazing for teaching color mixing, and also gives you a very similar vibe as you would get for, or result as you get with your paints. So it's so similar. I highly encourage that you use your oil pastels. So you can check it out with like that. Or if you really want to use paint, no problem. We can use paint as well. So we got blue. And then we're gonna get yellow. Mix it in the middle to make green. Okay, so lots of ways to use it. The option is really yours on how you want to go about it. Feel free to experiment. So fun. You can also teach about complementary colors in this resource. So you can be coloring each of these animals with complementary colors. So the frog could be red and green, one color for the background, one color for the animal, then blue and orange, one color for the background, one color for the animal, and so on. Okay, so it talks about what the complementary colors are, and then you can color the animals with them. A fabulous color wheel is included in this resource. It has your tints, your hues, and your shades. So you can go through with your students and work on it. Dude, I love it. So again, you can use your paints, or you can use wax crayons or oil pastel or even pencil crayon for this. It's really up to you on what art medium you want to use with it. You don't necessarily have to use paint. You can, or you don't have to. Okay, so you can add white to make a tint. The hue is the color. And then a shade. I'm also gonna show it on white, green as well, because yellow is one of those ones that's a little bit more tricky to see. But look how amazing it is just using wax crayons. Like, oh my goodness. And then they can mix your secondaries in there as well. So it has your secondary, sorry, and your tertiary. I pointed to the wrong one. Green is your secondary. All right, so I will even show mixing your own green to get green. So we'll add yellow. Or you can just use green. If you don't want to go that far, you can give them green to use. So yellow, what did I, oh yeah, blue. There you are, blue. And this is wax crayon, so I'm gonna have to layer it a little bit more with some yellow to get that nice green. Okay, and I can add white and black is somewhere right here. Okay, or we'll do blue, and then I'm just going to use a nice dark color here so you can see that I'm done with it. Okay, so blue. Or again, if you don't want to do mixing with, you know, mixing up your own, you can have them use a color. Or if you're doing paint, this is definitely a different way to use it again. Okay, so we'll do our shade. And a tint. Beautiful. Okay. Or if you wanted to use paint, no problem. Maybe we'll do red. Okay, so I'll do my hue. Then I'm gonna do red plus black. And then to make my tint, we need red, and we'll add white. Okay, so lots of ways to use this resource. You can use oil pastel. It's up to you on what you want to use. Have fun and experiment with it, but it's a fabulous color wheel option. Also shows doing value and creating a value scale. So they're gonna make their own gray value scale, but then also make a monochromatic scale using a color and medium of their choice. Pencil crayon would be perfect for that. They'll do tints, tones, and shades. So tint is color plus white makes a tint, color plus gray makes a tone, color plus black makes a shade. And then they'll be using their tint, tones, and shades on a still life to create something. And then we'll talk about analogous colors. Beautiful resource to show that. Neutral colors, we'll explore the neutral colors and what they are and using it on a still life. Monochromatic color schemes, coloring with the warm and cool colors, and so many more. So this is a fabulous art resource. There are so many more pages in here. So let's take a look at the full resource and go through it as a screenshot preview thing. So I'm gonna show you every single page that you're gonna get. And my friend, I know this is essential. So let's check it all out and go through the whole thing together. Thank you. the link in the description of this video and find the resource there. And then again, you'll find so many more details on it when you visit it in my Teachers Pay Teacher store, Ms. Artastic. So let's make some art.